Hello, and welcome to this week's Friday Live at SUSUtv with me, Andrew.
And I'm Jamie. This week's a special performing arts edition with content from the theatre group and the Medics Review.
We also have the usual current update and a new exclusive of today's record-breaking Movember turnout.
However, coming up first, we have a special interview with one of the NUS campaigners.
Oh, seriously, not another one. I know it's important, but they must run out of stuff to talk about eventually.
Don't worry, Anjit. It's not yes to NUS. It's not even no to NUS. Today's interview is with the increasingly popular meh to NUS. Let's see what they have to say.
We are joined today by Doug Thompson and Lucy Upshaw from the Meh to NUS team. So Lucy and Doug, thank you for coming today. A lot of people don't actually know what the NUS referendum is. A lot of people are a bit unsure and students don't really care that much. So why do you think Meh to NUS, albeit tongue-in-cheek, has come about?
I think it's more that students, like, I don't know, they just don't really know either what the referendum's about, or like they don't know what effect it's going to have on them, or like some of them don't actually know what SUSU is. So, what can I say?
Population don't really know what it is.
Yeah, we've got a pretty sick campaign to be fair.
Do you think this means they would rather we didn't join the NUS because there's no point in things changing, and if they haven't heard a lot about it, do they really want the NUS anyway?
I think some people don't realise the changes that it would make. They just see it to be like 50% off Spotify. So if there was more information, then maybe there would be more people interested, and yes and no would have bigger campaign teams like us.
Yeah, I think like because like a lot of people don't have any involvement in SUSU anyway, so you know it's not going to affect them at all. Like regardless, that's kind of it, I guess.
Yeah, definitely. Do you think the SABs need to be giving out more information before they start all this campaigning? Because we know a lot of them are yes to NUS, but no one even knows what the NUS referendum is. So do you think they should have started by giving out more information so that people who are meh would know more about it?
I know it's dangerous to have an opinion on my team, but I'm getting quite old now. You can see I've got a beard and stuff. Back in 2010, when we had the last referendum, we had a fact sheet straight off. We've just had this. I think it's a WordPress going up now. Moggy made it, where it's got an impartial list of points and all that sort of thing. That's kind of cool, but that's only just appeared. At the start of the 2010 referendum, yeah. That was there immediately anyway. So I don't know. We yearn for the 2010 referendum. We miss it. Yeah.
I think that it's just people like the yes and no teams jumping on kind of like each other in terms of when you say something, someone from each team will just jump on it in a way to persuade you, yes or no. So meh is just the fact, and yes or no, just do whatever.
So on the 6th, when the referendum takes place, what are you guys going to be doing? Are you going to be on Twitter, like just commentating, or are you going to attend and like see what happens? Are you going to vote?
We might vote if we can be bothered, but we'll be on Twitter. We'll probably be covering the events of the day from an impartial / I don't know, not really caring angle. Like normal, basically. Like we did with the debates, but just all day.
Brilliant. Thanks, guys. Oh, and where can we find you online if we want to find out more about meh to NUS?
Hashtag meh to NUS. That's MEH. And on Facebook, there's a group as well, so make sure you like it.
Just meh to NUS Southampton on Facebook.
You can add us on Facebook too, because we always like tag stuff.
Yeah, and we like having lots of Facebook friends. That's very important.
Thanks, guys.
If you're looking for more information about meh to NUS or any other campaigns, you can find their pages on Facebook.
Remember that as well as tuning in to the final Friday Live this year, this Friday, it's your chance to vote in the NUS referendum to decide the future of your students' union.
Enough of that. For the past couple of weeks, SUSUtv has been busy planning the new culture show. Here's a sneak peek of what's to come.
Hello and welcome to The Culture Show,
where our team of gurus will be discussing the best in films, books and music.
Good morning, Vietnam! and also giving you solid, top-notch recommendations of what you should be listening to, reading, and watching.
So if you're a bookworm, film buff, or a music fan, don't go away. We'll have something for you. Trust me, you need this, you just don't know it yet.
Fantastic. If you're looking forward to this as much as we are, make sure you keep an eye on SUSUtv. You and me have only just joined SUSUtv. Have you gotten involved in much else?
Ha! No. I could never join a show. You know, there's so many people in there. I couldn't act or let alone speak with that many people watching, you know?
You know, Anjit, people online...
What?
Never mind.
No, what?
If you do fancy performing, check out what the theatre group have for us.
If I had to describe the Comedy Layers in one word, I would say it was hilarious.
Mental.
Total and utter shit. No, that's not the name.
Comedy.
Farcical.
Banterous.
Fantastical.
Crazy.
Funny.
My favourite moment in the play is when I get in a bit of a fight scene with... It's not quite as good as some of the fight scenes I've seen in the past. It's better. A lot better.
I like it when I get to hit Chris Wickham.
It's all good. The whole play's good.
The line which goes, my breasts of steel.
Biggest similarity between me and my character? I'd say simplicity, naivety.
I think it's probably the short fuse and the amount of times I beat people. That's one of my favourite pastimes as myself and as my character. I do like to beat people to a pulp.
The fact that I moan a lot. Probably the ditziness. Luciana isn't very particularly clever. I hope there aren't any, because she's really mean.
My favourite character probably is a toss-up between Angelo, Beatrice, the Dromios. The Dromios are hilarious.
Probably Luciana, because she's my character, and so I know her the best, and so she's my favourite.
There's so many great characters. Angelo is obviously funny for comic value. Beatrice is great. Adriana's great. They're all great. I love all the characters. We've got so many. Every person has managed to get a character which is really likeable and funny. So come and see The Comedy of Errors.
In the Alex Theatre from Wednesday to Saturday, 5th to the 8th of December.
Bring your family. It's just great fun for all. £8 adults, £6 students, for £5 if you've got a PA card. Come along.
You can buy tickets online here.
Or on the door. Or reserve by emailing.
It's going to be bloody brilliant.
If you think that... Oh, sorry.
Well, if that did look like a lot of fun.
Yeah. If you think that was fun, wait till later. The producer has got a surprise challenge for us. I heard a rumour that it might involve bondage and... What? Hold on a second. Let me just Google bondage.
Oh, God, Andrew.
Yeah, bondage. Bear with me for a sec. Oh. 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 Apparently, yep. Good. We're all good. I know what bondage is, but...
Well, moving on. That'll be a first on SUSUtv. Don't worry. I'll be gentle.
Jamie, I don't think they actually meant it in that way. But before we venture down that traumatic tunnel, let's have a look at the medical review from you. Medic's Review is currently running this weekend. Be sure to buy a ticket and go see it. I have been bondaged.
Andrew, so all jokes aside, we have been tied up, haven't we? Some SUSUtv elves have come in and worked their magic, and I think it's time for us to do the challenge.
You guys are. Welcome, presenters, to the challenge for this week. This week, what you're going to have to do is, hands tied behind your back, eat this cake.
Fucking hell.
With your face. Best of luck.
Not too bad.
What if I don't like jam?
Up and start now.
Should we bend over?
Ah!
Are we still alive?
You've also got one minute, so hurry up and stuff. TikTok. TikTok. Get moving.
Right, bend over.
My mic is stuck in the board behind
me. Same.
Oh, they can't move. Interesting. Well, man up. Get involved.
My mic is.
Yeah, the mic.
We don't care. Presenters, you are hopeless. We're getting in some technical help to try and deal with this. Please just eat the cake. Come on. What's up with this?
Set fire to your hair. Poke a stick at a grizzly bear. Eat medicine that's out of date. Use your private parts as a ground bait. Dumb ways to die. So many.
It will be my peak in 2 seconds.
Get your toast out with a fork. Do your own electric
work. There's cake in here, at least.
Teach yourself how to fly.
You have taken far too long to do this, so we're giving you the punishment for this week for failing to complete the challenge, which is just eat cake. You now have to deal with that. Helper, please now do the same to Anjit. I feel that's appropriate. Anjit, don't resist.
Yep.
Just go with it. This is bondage.
It's good.
Go into the cake.
Okay. I'm done. Yeah.
Fantastic.
It's fucking in the cake.
Helper, you can now leave. Helper, you can now leave. That was beautiful.
Right, we didn't say anything about it, right?
Okay,
I wonder what's different.
I'm afraid you're going to do
that. That was the presenter's challenge this week. We apologise for their incompetence. Here comes an interesting fact about Movember.
So, we've all done Movember mainly because I've made these guys do it, but also because we want to support RAG and help out like Prostate Cancer UK.
This is kind of one of the good chances we had to work together, not just in RAG, but the whole of Southampton University, and even with Solent or something, which is like a joint project. And so we've got people going up to this world record attempt today, in fact.
Okay, so we're about 2 minutes away from hearing the final verdict and whether the guys here have broken the world record attempt. We've got Steph here, who's going to be announcing it in a couple of minutes. Are you excited?
I'm really excited to see how much money we've raised, actually. I think that everyone here has been, from what I've seen, extremely generous, so I'm really excited to see how much money.
Excellent.
494 of you here in the Guildhall Square. But as I said, today has not been about breaking world records. It's actually been about raising money for Prostate Cancer UK.
There we go. Watch has just said there we've broken a European record for Movember. So that's an excellent effort. We had 494 guys turn up today and support Movember. So that's excellent news. Hey.
Glad to see that it wasn't just us having stuff all over our faces today.
Exactly. As you can see, that world record was filmed this morning and edited before our live show. If you fancy doing something similar, make sure you like the SUSUtv Facebook page to receive updates on when and where you can take part and join us.
Well, that's it for today's show. Meet us next week for the final Friday Live this year, which will feature extra Christmassy features as well as a very special challenge.
So from all of us here at SUSUtv, goodbye.
Good night.
Sweet dreams.